Alright, welcome back. We're going to be playing some more Zelda Ocarina of Time for the N64, Switch, 3DS, whatever you're playing on. This all works. Alright, so we've got two spiritual stones, only one left. Before we go get it, let's go get all the secrets available to us at this point. First, run down Death Mountain as if you're going to go back to Kakariko Village, and on your left there is a wall to bomb. Behind it is a gold skulltula. Now head for Goron City by running up. Here you will find a Goron rolling around on the middle level. Here's an easy way to get him to stop. Remember, you want him to stop inside of this tunnel. Smashing into him with a bomb, in my opinion, is the easiest way to catch him. Talk to him for an upgrade for your bomb back. Now head back up to the top and bomb the rocks in your way and follow along, and you come to this maze. Just bomb your way through as shown here to get to the other side for some delicious treasure full of rupees. Now roll into the crate nearby for another gold skulltula. Alright, now it's time to continue up to the top of Death Mountain, so follow the trail up and bomb this rock in your way. Keep going and you will be caught in falling rocks from the volcano on top of Death Mountain. With your Hylian shield equipped, just stay in block position to stay safe and then creep your way to the other side. Now it's time to kill these spiders so we can climb up. At the top, after speaking to this annoying owl, head to the path on the right. Now it's really hot in here and you can only survive for not very long, but smash open that crate right in front of you for a gold skulltula, then exit and re-enter to restart the time. Now quickly run over to this side and line yourself up with this Triforce platform you see right here and walk forward. Don't worry, you won't fall, but you can climb down and get this heart. You can jump into the lava after you get the heart. I had a fairy, so it reset the timer for me when I did it, but if you do jump in the lava, it just starts you back at the entrance in which you can exit, and you only lose one heart for doing that. In any case, just make sure you get out of there. Now, time to bomb the area to the left of the owl and head inside for a great fairy fountain where you get a magic power. The fairy seductively leaves. Now, back outside, talk to the owl who will fly you back down to Kakariko Village, but you will be now on top of the house. Head over to the edge where you can see the chicken lady from earlier, just as shown here, and then carefully jump down. Head in the door and you will be able to snag another heart piece. Now head back to Hyrule Castle Town. A new shop has opened, the Bomb Tube Bowling Alley. Use your bombs to bowl past obstacles. It can be difficult and the prizes rotate between regular bombs, bomb chews, a bomb bag, a upgrade, and a piece of heart. Play it until you at least get the bomb shoes, the bomb bag upgrade, and most importantly, the piece of heart. The game can be hard, just try to use the lines on the floor to guide you to aim properly and try to time out the chickens so that you can get past them. Remember that room back at the entrance of Hyrule Castle Town full of rupees if you need more to keep playing. Now after you get those prizes, head into the castle area, climb the vines, run over to this area here, and use a bomb to blast open this cave. Go inside for another great fairy fountain and another magical power. Now leave and go back out into Hyrule Field. Head for the area right before you zone into Lake Hylia, right inside this gate as shown here. If you have rumble feature on, you will feel it rumbling here. If you don't have it, then this is the spot right here. Bomb it, go inside, defeat the scrub, and buy a piece of heart for 10 rupees. Alright, now run over to Lost Woods and head through the maze as shown here. Once you get to this second boulder, blast it and jump in the hole, and the closest scrub there will sell you a Deku Nut upgrade for 40 rupees after you defeat him. Okay, now finally, it's time to go to Zora's Domain and get that last spiritual stone. The owl bothers you. As soon as he shuts up and flies away, roll into the tree that is to the left of the boulders for a gold skulltula, and then bomb the boulders and continue forward. You'll see a chicken. Ignore it, but we'll be back for it later. Keep going and you'll see a little dude eating out of a bag. Talk to him and buy as many of these magic beans as you can afford, just to make sure you can keep buying as many as possible. I'm going to be showing you a spot with 200 rupees to fill you up, but spend what you got now and then use a bean on this soft patch right beside him. Now, this soft patch does not have a gold skulltula, so no need to drop bugs in this one, just the bean. It sprouts, which seems useless, but we'll be using it later. Now, leave this entire area and go all the way back to Kakariko Village, which actually isn't far, and behind the tree, right in this exact spot, I want you to drop a bomb to find a secret entrance. Jump down, and then play the Sun Song to kill the zombies, and then open the chest for 200 rupees. Now head back to the little dude we were at earlier and buy as many magic beans as you can. Now go back and get that chicken. We need him to get some secrets. So use the chicken and go on along using him to carefully fly across gaps. Now when you get to this part, to get the heart container, you will use the chicken and then throw it right when you get to the ledge. So you can climb on up, then jump right on across and get that heart container. Now jump back down and grab that chicken again. Carefully bring him along with you all the way up the trail and all the way up until this point you see here. Climb up on the highest platform where the waterfall is at your back and jump down, letting the chicken glide you right down to this heart piece. Now play the Sun Song to make it night and jump down into this area here and get the Gold Skullutula. Climb up the ladder, stand on the platform here right in front of the waterfall, play Zelda's Lullaby, and the waterfall parts, and you can now enter Zora's Domain. So head on inside. Okay, first things first, run all the way up to the very top, and you will see a lit torch. Light a Deku stick with it as quick as you can, run down and light the first torch down some steps, then go on down, and you need to light this torch in front of this door, and that door is actually the shop, by the way. Then run across the water. Right here you see these round kind of rocks, and get this torch, and then quickly run behind the waterfall here and light these two torches. It may take a couple of tries, but when you get them all lit fast enough, a chest will fall and it has a piece of heart inside. Now run all the way back up to the top again, and this time take a left and go find this Zora. Talk to him for a diving game. It's super easy. Dive down once it starts and then go underwater and use the shadow of Link to aim to swoop down and grab the rupees at the bottom, and a lot of times you can grab two at a time. After you get them all though, run back up top and talk to the Zora again for your prize. Now you can dive way deeper in the water now with this prize. So dive back down, dive into the water here to warp to Lake Hylia. As soon as you zone in, you see the item we need, a bottle. Dive down and grab it, then take it back to land and use it to read the letter inside. Swim back through the hole you came through to go back to Zora's Domain. Run over here and use one of your other bottles to swipe up a fish. We are going to need that later. Now run all the way back up to the top and talk to the King of the Zoras. He moves out of your way, and now run up to the passage he revealed. Now swim out and find this little island in the southeast of the map and roll into the tree on it for a Gold Skullutula. Now lay a bomb right here to blow open a secret entrance and inside for a third Great Fairy Fountain. Get your magical power and head on back out. Now swim back around to the front of this giant creature, which is Jabu Jabu, and use the fish in the bottle we caught earlier. He will suck the fish and you into his belly. It's dungeon time. There's some mild annoyance of monsters in this dungeon. Once we get the next item, all these will be much easier to kill though, so you'll mostly be running away from them until then. So run over to the door that is locked with webbing, turn around, and look up with the slingshot and shoot this dangly down thing in the back of Jabu's throat to open the door. In this room, just run away from these monsters in here. They are just a pain. Head into this door you see here, and you will meet the Princess of the Zoras. She has a slight attitude problem, and then karma gets her real good, and she falls into this whole thing. Jump down after her and talk to her twice until she agrees to join you, as long as you carry her around, of course. Don't worry, she will be useful, and this will be quick. Run on through as I show here. Lots of annoying creatures. Just continue onward until you get to this part. Now jump on down and toss the Zora up to safety on the other side. Kill these guys. Kill the Gold Skullutula up on the webbing. Then hit the switch, which brings the water up temporarily so you can climb up and get the token. Now when the water goes back down, hit the switch again and then swim over to the other side with the Zora. Now head through this hallway and you will come to another locked door. Put down the Zora and shoot this with your slingshot to open that door up. In this room, put down the princess and knock back the attack of the Octorok to kill it. Pick up the Zora and wait for the elevator. Hop on and ride it on up. Now we are back in this room. Go through this door here. Go to the other side of the room. Watch out for the holes as you go. Now this hallway has three passages to the north, one passage to the far left, and one to the far right. Avoid the enemies here if you can, and head over to this switch. It will only work if you are holding Rudo. I'm not calling her fat, I'm just saying we need the extra weight. Go through the door, put the Zoroarudo down, and kill these annoying guys by walking over them and then killing them with your slingshot. A chest appears when they are all dead, and inside is the boomerang, which is great because we will be using it to kill basically everything in this dungeon. Grab Rudo and run to the other end of this area, step on the switch here, and then put the Zora down on top of the switch to hold it down and go through the door without her. She will be mad, but you gotta do what you gotta do. Inside is a tentacle tail. Use your boomerang, stay moving, and every time it comes down, let the boomerang loose until it is defeated. Each hit makes it retreat back up to the top. Just walk towards the middle of the room under it, and it will come back down for you to hit it again. Just keep moving, don't stand still. Now go back out, take a verbal thrashing from Rudo, pick her up, and head this way, where you must kill all the bubbles quickly. Now use your boomerang, and then you will get the compass if you kill them all in time. If not, you just don't get the compass, and that's okay. Just keep following the guide, you'll be fine. Now head towards where you got the boomerang and head into this room. Another tentacle tail, same strategy, take it down, keep moving. Exit and go for this middle room now, and inside is the last tentacle. Use the same strategy, but you might want to kill the jellyfish here first to make it easier. Once you kill the tail, head back to the main room where you first found Rudo. This is the hole right here you want to fall into. Make sure it is this one. Make sure you pick the correct hole. When you fall down, it is a platform you couldn't have reached without defeating all the tentacles before. Now get these two skulltulas using your boomerang to kill them, and then the boomerang to get the tokens from afar. Pretty neat. Now head through this hallway and into this door. Inside, Rudo sees the spiritual stone. Throw her up there where she grabs it, and then a trap takes her up without you, and you hear her scream. Then the mini boss comes down. Now listen, the easiest way to defeat this guy is to hit him with your boomerang. He starts spinning, hit him while he's spinning again with the boomerang, and then slash him with your sword right in his booty butt. Do this 3 times and he will be defeated. Now get on the platform it takes you up. Get a fairy here if you want. You can catch it in a bottle, and if you die, it will bring you back to life with full health. Now go through the only door here. Kill the Octorok because he is annoying, and then take out the jellyfish guys. Now stand in this spot right here and hit this thing with your boomerang. It freezes it, and you can jump across and then do the same to the second one. Quickly though, the freeze doesn't last long, and then jump on across to the door. Get on this platform, it will take you up and connect in a room you have been before, but now with this platform you can run over and grab one of these small crates and carry it back across the platform and place it on this switch to hold it down. Now go through the door that it opens. Now in this room, kill all the bad guys, then head over to the area on the vines, kill the gold skulltula, climb up to get the token, climb up to the very top, and then stand, you gotta stand a little back from this clear looking wall piece here and Z target the switch. Use your boomerang, and if you are far enough back from the clear wall, it will go around it and hit the switch, opening the door. Head on in, and guess what? It's boss time. First, use your boomerang to take out the 3 tentacles, attaching it to the ceiling. Keep moving while you do this, and after all 3 are down, it starts swinging jellyfish around. This can be tricky, but keep swinging your boomerang until it slips past the defenses and hits the soft, vulnerable part on the inside. This freezes it, and all the jellyfish come unattached. Z target and get as many of these jellyfish as you can, as quick as you can. Now that it has less jellyfish to swing, it makes it easier to hit the boss with your boomerang, freezing it and releasing the jellyfish again. Each time, take out as many of the jellyfish until they are all gone. This will start phase 2. Where he starts spinning all around. Now what you want to do is target his main body and get close enough to hit him with the boomerang. Once again, the jellies come loose and you must take them out with your boomerang. Keep repeating this until they are all gone. Now it's time for phase 3, where he's spinning around the room, shooting out electricity from the top. Just make sure you stay moving, strafing around him, and that you have him Z-targeted and hit him with the boomerang to stun him. Then run in for some slashes of your sword. Keep repeating this until you have him defeated. Enjoy the cutscene and stay tuned for the next episode in which we wrap up the rest of the secrets for this portion of the game and go to turn in our 3 spiritual stones to Princess Zelda. Exciting times. Please like, subscribe, and comment for more.